all the tapes. Former senior advisor President Reagan, Pat Buchanan, joins us. Nice to see you, Pat.
Good to see you, Greta.
All right, so this certainly does divide the two candidates. Are these good synopsis of the two different positions?
This is good to have this division, this argument, Greta, because this is what this campaign should be about. Frankly, it is what this generation is all about. You have in the United States of America something approaching half of the American people now who pay no income taxes, and half the American people who strictly get benefits from government. What Governor Romney was saying is it's hard to appeal to folks on the basis of tax cuts when they pay no taxes, and then you say we got to pare back the welfare state, but they do get all these benefits. Look, this is the great issue of our time. We see it ongoing in Europe. You see it in California. You see it in these cities that are going under. Can you have a system of society where there are far more tax consumers than there are taxpayers? John C. Calhoun said that is the beginning of the end of a democratic republic, and we are in the fail-safe zone right now and almost crossing that line. This is a great debate to have in the end of this campaign.
All right, well, there is some battle over what the 47% means. I mean, how many people pay taxes or don't pay taxes? I'm not going to get into the hair splitting of this, but I'm curious, how do the two campaigns get these points out to the American people? Because this has sort of the discussion of some sort of salon where people talk about this, you know, about the different issues. I mean, how do they make these real for the people?
I think the way they do it is Governor Romney should do it. Now, where I disagree with Governor Romney, of those 47%, you got good folks down there in Florida. Let's say a retired couple, a fellow's a sergeant in the Army, he and his wife getting Social Security, maybe veterans benefits, not paying taxes. Those folks are with you. Governor Romney shouldn't write off any voters, but there's other folks clearly that are getting all these benefits that really, really just live off the benefits and aren't trying. He's going to have a tough time with them. If I were him, I would use examples. Use the state of California. Look at what is happening in Illinois. You've got a liberal mayor and a very liberal union. They are at war with each other inside the party of the public sector. Look at Europe. Look at France. Look at Spain. Look at Greece. Look at Italy. The public sectors have gotten so huge that these places are collapsing and people are leaving. That is what is happening to us. 37% of our entire GDP now is consumed by government. 25% at the federal level, 12% at the state and municipal level. It's about 55% in France. This is the great cause of our time. Are we going down the road? Barack Obama, in my judgment, is a Fabian socialist. You saw the redistribution, and by that I mean he's not Bernie Sanders, who's right out in the open and honest about it, but he's a Fabian socialist who wants to move through gradualism and reform step by step until a majority of Americans are dependent upon government. When that happens, the party of government wins every election.
You know, I'm sort of curious. We have only this snippet of it, and I always want the whole thing so I'm satisfied I can put it in context. But what's interesting is that what he said was, in part, and I realize it's only part, said, I think what we're going to have to do is somehow resuscitate the notion that government action can be effective at all. In the last 4 years, has he resuscitated the notion that the government action can be effective?
No. Look, let's take one example. Food stamps. I grew up in D.C. 800,000 people here in D.C., born in the 30s during the Depression, grew up in the 50s. Nobody in D.C. of those 800,000 was on food stamps. City's now 600,000. One in every five people are on food stamps.
What happened?
This is just it. The whole idea, we used to have read FDR about, you know, relief being a narcotic, a subtle destroyer of the human spirit. We got to get off this welfare, is what he said. In that sense, if it's a narcotic, Barack Obama is a drug dealer of welfare. He wants permanent dependency, in my judgment, of all these folks on the federal, somehow getting benefits, and paying no taxes. Now, I think you got it. Governor Romney is the complete opposite. We believe in temporary help for anybody that's in trouble. You should have a floor of decency under any family. Unemployment should be temporary. Unemployment benefits should be. Food stamps should be temporary. What are we doing with 47 million people permanently have to be fed by the government?
Well, it's much easier to move people off food stamps and move them off unemployment if the economy is revved up and going, if they had someplace to go.
It is indeed. But look what we did in the 90s, the Republicans and Bill Clinton did. They said, okay, 2 years on welfare and then off. You got to get workfare. You got to go get a job. You cannot, look, the society cannot carry forever a huge, vast, and growing class of folks who are permanently dependent upon the government of the United States and state and local government, while you're shrinking the number of people that are contributing and paying the taxes. When the tax consumers outnumber the taxpayers, it is all over for the GOP, and it is all over, I think, for this republic.
I suspect if President Obama were here, he would say the reason that he talks about the redistribution is because he doesn't want the United States to become an essentially a gated community where you have the haves and the have-nots. It's so extreme that even the haves have to live behind bars to be protected.
Ronald Reagan said something different. He said, a floor of decency under every family, but no roof over any man's head. This idea, look, redistribution, it's got to be permanent. Because the most successful, hardest worker, most energetic, most ambitious, they're going to rise up and make more and more and more. He's going to come in and scoop it off for eternity to give to folks who aren't making that much. That is socialism. That's not the country we grew up in.
Whatever happened to our middle class?
Well, the middle class is shrinking. One of the things is the mammoth size and dependency of governments at all levels. I mean, 37% of GDP going for government. Look, that's like World War II. I grew up here during World War II. It used to be we were down at 20, 25%. It's 37. The French are at 55. They're raising the tax rate to 75%. They got the rich guys are headed for Belgium.
Pat, always nice to see you, sir.
Oh, it's delightful.